frozen vaccines, specifically cell-associated vaccines, require special care. For optimal results, we will walk through important steps in the preparation, mixing, and delivery of frozen Marek's disease vaccines, commonly used for Inovo injection. Frozen cell-associated vaccines are stored in liquid nitrogen until ready for use. Take precautions when handling vaccines in liquid nitrogen. It's important to check liquid nitrogen levels daily. If nitrogen levels in the large Dewar flasks are less than 3 inches, 7.5 centimeters, contact your supplier. Designate a vaccine preparation room in a controlled work area of the hatchery. Only vaccine personnel should be permitted entry, and the space should have a daily, weekly, and monthly cleaning schedule to ensure the environment is the cleanest room in the hatchery. Positive room pressure is highly recommended. Clean or replace ventilation filters monthly and ensure airflow is not directed at the vaccine preparation surface area. With clean, sanitized hands, disinfect a non-porous working surface with alcohol before getting started. Remember to disinfect the work surface between the mixing of each bag of vaccine. If applying non-Marek's vaccines for spray application on hatched chicks, use a separate area, syringes, dyes, antimicrobial bottles, and thaw baths to prepare vaccines to segregate and avoid cross-contamination. Preparing the thaw bath is an important step in the vaccine preparation process. Wash thaw bath with soap and water daily. Let dry and spray down with alcohol. Fill the thaw bath with distilled water. Add chlorine to the bath for a final concentration of 200 parts per million or 15 milliliters of 5% bleach or sodium hypochlorite per gallon of water, 4 milliliters per liter of water. Then allow time for water to reach a temperature of 80 degrees Fahrenheit or 27 degrees Celsius. Diluents should be used at room temperature. Be sure to follow manufacturer recommendations for vaccine use, as well as guidance by your veterinarian. Inspect diluent for clarity. Use only clear diluents when preparing vaccine, and discard cloudy diluents. If a diluent appears damaged, stop using immediately and notify your supplier. Use a separate sterile needle and syringe for each product added to the diluent. Remember to wipe the port of the diluent with alcohol each time something is added to or extracted from the diluent. Simply wipe the port with alcohol and allow the surface to dry for 5 seconds before inserting needle. Be sure to follow manufacturer recommendations for vaccine use, as well as guidance by your veterinarian. Next, add all additives and non-Marek's vaccines aseptically to the diluent. It's important to add the Marek's vaccine as the last step. Be sure to dispose of needles in a sharps container immediately after use. Once you're ready to start the thawing process of the Marek's vaccine, it's important to prepare a syringe to receive the vaccine. To do this, draw 5 milliliters of diluent into a 20 milliliter syringe that has an 18 gauge needle and is 1.5 inches long. This small amount of diluent begins the process to buffer the vaccine. Next, remove vaccine ampules from a liquid nitrogen container following these safety steps. First, always wear eye protection and insulated gloves, and avoid inhaling liquid nitrogen vapor when checking levels daily. Second, always use caution when handling the ampules, since ampules can explode with a sudden temperature change. To remove ampules, pull the cane out of the liquid nitrogen container only as far as needed, and detach the number of ampules needed. When thaw bath is at temperature, thaw no more than 4 ampules at a time and only thaw them for 70 to 90 seconds. Time begins when the ampule is removed from the liquid nitrogen container. Total time from thawing to addition of the diluent should be no more than 150 seconds or 2.5 minutes. Immediately after thawing and before opening ampule, dry hands and ampule with a clean paper towel. Use a new paper towel with each thawing sequence of 4 or fewer ampules. Next, open ampules by pointing the top of the ampule away from the face and body, and carefully break the ampule at the neck. Do not spill the contents of the ampule. Then, using the 20 milliliter syringe containing buffered diluent, begin the process to remove the vaccine from the ampules. Do not allow needle to touch the outside of the ampule or any other surface except the inside of the ampule or the septum of the vaccine bag. If this occurs, discard the needle, syringe, and contents. Do not risk possible contamination of the vaccine and diluent. Slowly draw contents of the ampule into the syringe containing diluent. Slightly tilting the ampule will ensure all vaccine is removed. This should take approximately 3 seconds. Fast drawing or injecting can cause cell damage to the vaccine and reduce its potency. Use of an ampule holder is recommended to reduce the risk of self-injection and helps ensure a more stable platform for this process. Slowly add contents of the syringe to the bag of the diluent once vaccine has been extracted from the thawed ampules. If recommended by a veterinarian, rinse ampule once with a small amount of diluent, making sure not to overfill or spill rinse. Add this to the vaccine diluent mixture. On each bag, write the time the vaccine is added with a dark-colored marker. Mix the contents of the diluent container thoroughly by massaging and inverting the bag about 10 times. Do not shake vigorously and avoid creating bubbles. The vaccine is ready for use. After mixing, place the vaccine in a cooler with clean plastic-covered ice packs. This will help prevent the vaccine from getting warm. Transport the vaccine to the vaccination device in the cooler and keep inside until ready to hang in device. Dry the outside of the bag thoroughly with a new, clean paper towel before hanging. For Embrex Innovoject, place the vaccine bag in the intertherm bag with ice packs to provide ongoing chilling during use. Use aseptic technique to attach the vaccine bag to the Embrex bio device using the IV spike. This should be done by a designated clean staff member. Then, remove the IV port cover, swab spike with alcohol, and insert the spike into the bag. Prime bio device vaccine system to remove any air bubbles and assure vaccine delivery to all needles of the Embrex bio device. At this point, visually observe needles and vaccine dispense for proper flow. Return transport cooler to the lab. Prepared vaccine must be used within 1.5 hours from the time of preparation. Recommendations may differ according to vaccine type and manufacturer. During Innovo vaccination, vaccine temperature will be between 35 degrees Fahrenheit to 50 degrees Fahrenheit. Finally, keep a daily log of vaccine types, lot numbers, expiration dates, bag size, vaccine amounts, and other additives used per bag. Zoetis stands ready to train your team on proper vaccination protocols in the hatchery. To find even more ways to improve your team's vaccination performance, contact your Zoetis representative.